Good morning. It's Happy Saturday. This is the Geeky Minecrafter bringing you another in the Let's Play series. Today we're at, where are we? We're Cherry Vanilla. I've been given permission to create a shop down in Spawn, and I've put the framework up. I haven't done much else. It's time for me to gather up some materials, take it down there, and see if I can't make a shop. I thought I'd include you in that, because it's going to be trial and error. This is more about let's play and less about a tutorial. So, come on, let's go ahead and get started. So, back here at my base. Sun's just coming up, and it's a beautiful day. Now, I'm going to go the long way. Oh, actually, I'm sorry. I meant to grab some of this dark oak right over here. Okay. Well, let's see if we have enough to get started. How about that? Gosh, the last couple of times I've come up here, I've had creeper holes to deal with. I've replaced this area right up here like 3 or 4 times now. So let's go see if we can get there without getting blown up. There is a yellow sheep over there. And there's still a rail in front of my... front of my house. I don't know what that's about. Okay, to the hub. The nether hub. This long hallway here, I think, has 3 residents on it. Dee Dee Does Games and Eric, Will, and myself. It's a pretty nice area where we live. I live in a dark oak forest, which is why I'm kind of shocked I don't have more dark oak in the chest. These lead to hallways to other areas, and this leads to the spawn. So if this is the first time you've ever seen Cherry Vanilla, know that it is a whitelisted server. You can ask to be on the server. You have to put in an application. Come on, let me out. We're lagging a little bit. Okay. You can ask to be placed on the server. Ask for a, what do you call this, a P.O. box. Okay. And you can store things here for yourself, or people can leave you mail here or whatever. I'm actually getting ready for a server reset. We're going to get to take this one double chest with us. So I am steady gathering resources. So I'm putting everything in there that I want to take to the 1.9 server upgrade. It'll be a brand new world. Oh my goodness. There's a lot of excitement getting ready for that. I don't know when it'll happen. Oops, I think I missed it. Yep. Turn right at the sugar cane place. Let's scooch around right here. I heard a zombie. Did you hear a zombie? I heard a zombie. Oh, you know what? I don't have, oh, look at this. Oh, some well wishes. So I had originally placed a sign up here that asked, you know, can I set up a shop? And then had some health issues with Mom and wasn't able to get started right away. And came back and there was a giant "you may" standing right here over this shop plot. And and several other signs saying, yes, yes you can, yes you may, you know, I mean, because I wasn't responding, so I think they were trying to get... Uh-oh, what happened here? Did we have a creeper blow up? It just blew up the wood? I don't understand. Somebody came and swiped the corner of my my shop? I don't know. Okay. So, a little bit of news. I ride a motorcycle. I have a big 750 that I ride whenever I can, and it's been non-functioning for a while, and my mechanic showed up to deliver it, and I rode for, I don't know, 5 minutes, and then ran into a problem. So I was this close to being able to go riding, but as you can tell, I didn't have a helmet on. I just was riding around the neighborhood. Here, let's do this, too. Okay, now, I just drew an outline. All I have to do is be able to put some chests in there. I don't really want to get all fancy-dancy here. Again, we're getting ready to move. There's no reason to... sorry, here. I'm set up for mining, not for building. There's no reason to get all crazy with the shop. Right? I just need a place to put some chests in here. I have some stuff I want to sell. I also wanted to see... I've never tried this. Have you? This is a set of stairs, a set of stairs, set of stairs. I want to know... Will these iron bars fit in here? No. But will they do better than the glass? I did not bring my silk touch, did I? Okay, let's go get my silk touch. Be right back. I love this server because it has a couple of, you can set home points. You can set up to 6 different home points. Here, I'll just grab this one. And I have one set for my bedroom and one set for the shop, so I can jump between them. Now I ran the long way because I want you to know where the shop is. If you're from Cherry Vanilla, I want you to be able to find where my shop is. So let's take this silk touch, get rid of this glass, and see if this iron does any better. No, it pretty much looks just like the glass, doesn't it? Well, which do you think looks best? The glass or the iron? You know, I think I'm gonna go with the iron. Yeah, I think I'm gonna go with the iron. I like it. Okay. So, again, what I thought I'd do, not much in here. I'm just going to have a row of chests all the way around. I need to go find some leather. So, let's see. I'm going to need a roof. I'm going to need some more. Let's see. 1, 2, 3, 4. Right? I like that. Want some air in here, want to be able to see. Now I had taken the sea lanterns, I guess, out to put the floor in. I'll be incorporating those back into the roof so that I have some lighting. And I don't necessarily want to do it with a bunch of torches. So let's make it match on both sides. 1, 2, 3, 4. Again, today it's less about being artistic and more about just getting things done. Okay, so we're going to go up. I'm going to try and put a roof on this place without dying. And I do want to go out a little bit. Let's see. Yeah, see, I'm a little bit further back than most people. I want to bring this up and over just a little, like just a little bit of an overhang. And then I'm going to put the roof line up here. I want kind of a vaulted ceiling. So, let's do that in dark oak. Tell you what, let's go up one. Like this. Again, less about artistic creativity and more about just getting it done. But I think I'm going to need a second story. Hopefully I'm going to have enough stuff to sell that's going to, good golly, he's crazy. Hi, the man himself. Hope you're having a wonderful Saturday. Okay, so let's do this. See, we're going to make this the floor, right? Let me put this in and see how high that is. Oh yeah, plenty high enough, right? Okay, that'll be the roof line, and then it'll go up like this, and we'll do the dark on the stairs as well. Best let them know, recording and live on Twitch. So, if you're just joining us, welcome. I'm sorry for not seeing your messages there. Geeky Minecrafter hanging out, doing a little bit of shop building. Let's see, I'm going to need... That's not much of a fall. I can do that. Okay. Trailblazer, and welcome. I saw that you followed me. I appreciate that. Is this your first time viewing the Minecraft Grand or the Geeky Minecrafter channel? Let me know in chat. Okay, this is a little bit frustrating. So here's what I propose. I think what I'm gonna do. I'm going to stop streaming, and I'm going to start recording with Camtasia. That way, I'll be able to pull it all together and cut it into one video. So, I'm sorry, we're not going to do it live. I'll continue the stream. I'll continue the shop building in camera only, and I'll publish it on my YouTube channel. I do go by the Geeky Minecrafter on YouTube. Do a search. You should be able to find all my videos there. I have both a Let's Play series and a live stream series, which this will be both. Good grief. So I appreciate you checking in with me. Until I get my technical difficulties worked out, I guess what I'm going to have to do is record with Camtasia and place it up here. I have placed messages on the forums for Twitch, and nobody's gotten back to me. This problem's been ongoing now for about 60 days. I've left support tickets. I don't know what to do. Okay, so I don't know if I captured the first two videos with the technical difficulties that I had. So I will be repeating myself. I apologize. Basically, I am building a shop in the Cherry Vanilla server. And I was streaming and it blew up a couple of times. So this is where I'd gotten to when it ended. So we're going to go from here. Okay? So, I've managed to get some of the roof on before I fell off over there when I was recording. So I need to jump back up there and finish the roof. Ooh, that was close. Let's see, how am I going to get up there? I've got a lot of scaffolding I'm going to wind up having to take down. There we go. Okay. So anyway, don't know if it's going to make it, but we've got a server reset coming. And I've got a bunch of surplus inventory that people might need. I don't know if they're even going to buy it. I don't know if they, you know, if they care. I don't know when the server reset is going to happen. And it could be that, you know, building a shop right now is absolutely futile. But I am looking forward to the experience. And I really thank THM or TMH for the man himself. That's what that stands for. TMH for granting me access to the shop. I'd like to become a shop owner on the new server as well, and I promise to do a better job. This is more about quick and dirty, and less about being really creative. So let's see, I've got a few things that are going to go into the shop. I've got some of the rarer items. I have spent quite a bit of effort in finding soul sand and growing netherwort for brewing. Oh, really? Again? Okay. Okay, where was I? I am not very good at streaming, talking, designing at the same time. So, where was I? I did tell you that I have trouble talking and designing at the same time. Yeah, you can see that, right? It's like walking and chewing gum. That was never my forte either. Okay, where was I? Can go. I don't want it to be said I'm encroaching on somebody else's property here. I want to keep it within the lines. That's my goal. You know, I was never very much of a color inside the lines kind of gal. Now, draw my own lines and then color it, sure. But color inside the lines somebody else drew, not so much. And maybe that's the fascination with Minecraft, at least for me. You know, you draw your own lines. Oops. There we go. It's getting dark. It's getting kind of hard to see this stuff. Okay, now you know what I don't know? Is how to build the shop itself. The chests. Well, look at this. Isn't this pretty? I haven't been up here before. That's the PvP area over there, I believe. Basically, there are small little worlds, and you can... Where's my... Oh, I got rid of the dirt. Nope, here it is. You can go player versus player in that little area. If you like, you know, wailing on each other. I'm not a big fan. Okay. Did I leave? I'm missing one. Is that what I'm doing here? No, that's my scaffolding. No? Okay. Let me go take a look from the front. Anyway, I'm not much of a whale on each other kind of player. To me, it kind of defeats the purpose of Minecraft. Minecraft for me is creativity. It's building. It's automating. It's learning new things. It's not trying to kill your friend. But I know for some people, you know, that's the lure. That's the game. So to you people, I say have big fun. Just don't be shocked when I don't want to play. Okay, I left the back side of this open. Or should I do steps this way? Well, I think what I'm going to wind up doing, rather than a second floor, is just an attic space. So I'll hide the steps. Yeah, we'll do that. Okay, so the roof's on. Let me put the bars up there. Do I have them with me? I have 20. I don't know if 20 is enough, and I didn't bring any iron with me. Well, we'll do what we have and go from there. Oh, walked right over that, didn't I? Yeah, not a very good judge of distances, apparently. Let's try. Okay, I want them here. Sorry about that. That's an alarm for me to remember my tasks. Connect, connect. I'm gonna have to jump up to be able to finish this, aren't I? Come on. Connect, connect, connect. Nope. Okay, I don't think that's gonna give me the look that I want. What was that? Oh, a wither. Somebody's fighting a wither? What do you think? Again, it doesn't have to be perfect. This is just about having a place to put some chests, right? Oh, that's disappointing. I'm so sorry, Trailblazer. That is frustrating, I'm sure. Okay, so let's get some more half slabs. Let's make sure I have my sea lanterns. And let's do the roof line. So I want to do the sea lanterns hanging down from the bottom of the, what do you call it, half slabs. So basically I'm going to want the half slabs to be on the high side, right? So at the top end of this, whatchamacallit, this block. Oh, man, my roof is kind of high. I'm going to have to do everything on dirt. That is disappointing. So, see what I'm saying? Put the slab here. Oh, really? Come on! Help me, Lord. You think I'd never walked around in Minecraft? And then that hanging below it. See how it'll drop down out of the ceiling? So I want to do the whole ceiling out of these half slabs like this. On something really tall, what I just did would have gotten me killed. I just know it. It's happened more than once. In fact, when I was building my gold farm, it happened 4 times in a row. So apparently, and for those of you playing Minecraft that don't know this, and you know, you laugh, but I didn't know this until very recently, if you are in sneak mode and you take yourself off of sneak mode, for example, to go into your inventory, even if you're still holding the key down, sneak mode goes away. Well, what happens when you then try to move? You've still got the key down, but sneak mode has been disengaged, so you fall. Yep, happened to me more than once, guys. Happened about 4 times, actually. Just to get into the point where I can remember to hold the sneak key down. Come on. And, you know, in an attempt not to fall, and then I discover, yep, getting into your inventory, that'll do it too. Oops, what was that? Yeah, that whole corner over there is all messed up, so let's get rid of my scaffolding here. Gotta love a really high-powered shovel. Okay, so we'll do this edge over here. Oh, I probably need to eat something. I'm gonna get rid of these baked potatoes. I'm a chicken kind of gal. In fact, I have a chicken farm that gives me all the chicken I can eat, and it's a lot more compact than that one. Whoever's chicken farm this is, I tell you what, I'm going to run show you a chicken farm that is super compact, and then you can message me when you're next online, and I can show you how to make that. So, it's got a really small footprint. Check this out. It is 3 wide, 9 deep, and now I haven't been over here, so, and I had just collected all the chicken. As a matter of fact, take a look at this guy or gal, whoever this is. Quite a bit of chicken up here. Now let me show you. Here, let's go in here to the maintenance area. Okay, so I have 25 chickens down here in the breeder cell, covered by trap doors, just like yours. Okay, I have 2 dispensers, 1 piece of redstone, 2 torches, and that's it. Okay, oh, a hopper, actually 2 hoppers, one under the breeder cell and one under the chickens that are being killed here. So, as you can see, I mean, I'm telling you, what is that, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 deep, 3 wide, 4 tall, 5 tall, I guess, counting the ceiling there, 5 tall. That's my chicken farm, and it just, you know, it does what it's supposed to do. You know, if you're in the area, you have to be within, what is it, about 40 blocks of the chickens for it to be going off, which is one of the reasons, you know, his is probably going crazy, because I'm right next to it, keeping it active, right? I say his. Please forgive the pronoun if you're a woman. It's not prejudicial or gender specific. I'm just, you know, his is a easy way to say it. So I get what you're doing, and it looks really cool, but there is a much smaller footprint way of doing that. So message me, and you know, I'll come build you one or show you how, or, you know, whatever you want to do. I don't know. Let's take a look. Yeah, it kind of ties it together a little bit. Okay, we'll go with that. It's, you know, it is what it is. Probably do that. Okay, so here's what I propose. I need to pause the video briefly, go read the forum on how to put the shop, chest together in the shop, and I'll be right back. And it gives you the information that you need to know, which is you create your chest, you put the first line, you put your name on the first line, the number of items per transaction on the second line. How much you're buying for, how much you're selling for, and then the item ID. And then you get the item ID, for example, like I'm holding a chest, so if I do item DB, then it'll tell me that I have a chest in my hand, it's 54:0. So, you know, when I put the things, items in the chest, is going to be when I need to create the sign. because I'll hold them. I'll get the item item from the or the item number from the DB database and place it on here. So I have a few items that I'm going to sell, but I don't have any of that stuff with me. I mean, this is all about creating the shop. So I'm going to need to run back to the house and get the items that I'm going to sell. I'm going to make several trips. I'm not going to make you watch me bounce back and forth between, you know, the house and here. So I will check back in once I have items in the chest that I'm going to sell. So stay tuned. I'll be right back. I have done a couple of extra things. I've emptied this, so I am going to take this upstairs and put this in the attic. Make this a part of my storage. Also need to get this out of here. Well, I don't think I have any dirt with me, do I? Nope, I just made one trip. Oh, I can't even pick that up. So I just made one trip up to the mine to get the last one, cobblestone. Oh, don't fall. Here we go. I'm going to put my extra stuff right up here. Let's see, do I have any dirt? Dirt? Hello? Here, this will work. So, let's go back downstairs. This is going to be my attic area, and as I need to bring things in, I'll bring them up here if the for sale chests are full. Now, as you can see, let me back up here and show you what I've done. I've basically just created a number of chests. They alternate between trapped and normal chests. I put a bunch of item frames up because sometimes it's unclear what's in here. For example, stone 3 is a variant. This is actually diorite, but it's a variant of the stone ID. So it's just not really clear what's what. So I went ahead and put item frames up to make it a little bit more clear. So I've got food items down here. I've got building block items over here. And I just went down to the mine and got a whole bunch of cobblestone. I do tend to save this. Now, I don't have as much as most people who mine as much as I do will have, because as I pull the ores out, I refill those with cobblestone. So I'm using a lot of the cobblestone that I pull out to make the mine look nice and tidy. But even at that, I do have quite a bit left over. So, I need, I'm gonna need one of those at least. Let's see. Oh, come on, really? So I can't put that in there because I only have the one. So I need to do two things. Here on the shop, as you can tell, it takes four lines. The name, your username, your in-game name is here. How many you're selling is here. The sell or buy price, and if you do both, for example, if I sold stone at 50, but I was willing to buy it at 30, then I could put the B space 30, and then a colon, and then S space 50, and that people could then sell me their cobblestone as well as I could buy it. And then what goes down below is typically the ID number or the constant. Now, what do I mean by constant? You see how I'm holding this in my hand, right? Here on this server, if I type item DB, it'll show me the constant is this first word right next to the word item. It's cobblestone, all in uppercase. Or I can put 4:0. See that? And it will also put cobblestone there. So I'm going to go ahead and use the constant. Let's see, is this where I put them? It is. Okay, so I'm going to shift. Oh, first I'm going to put this right up here. Now that I have the number, I'm going to shift click this sign and put my name. How many are in each stack, how many they're purchasing, my sell price, and frankly, you know, let's just get rid of it. Now again, I have less than most people do, but I still want to have an outlet for getting rid of it. Now I did do the obsidian in stacks of 10 because if you need to build a portal, that's how many are in a portal. If you want a bigger portal, buy a couple of stacks. So I finished putting this together. Let me go ahead and tell everybody we are open for business. So we'll say now open. And just to let them know, I am still stocking. Okay. So that's it. The store is done. I'll be able to bring in my surplus. I do have a few extras in here, like I want to bring in glass bottles, but I didn't have enough to really come and stock it. I've got to go get busy and make some. I've got a bunch of sand I need to convert to glass. I mean, it's a process. So I'm going to go finish filling the inventory of the store by first going in and collecting the inventory that I want to put in there. So I hope you've enjoyed this episode of Let's Play Minecraft with the Geeky Minecrafter. Stay tuned. We have more episodes coming soon. The next episode will probably be on a different server. I love Cherry Vanilla. As a matter of fact, it's my favorite multiplayer server. But I do have a big project going on one of the other servers, so I'll probably bring you a video from there. Until next time, this is the Geeky Minecrafter signing out. Happy mining!